By the end of the week, we should know whether St. Paul Public Schools will require all of its nearly 7,000 staff members to either show proof of COVID-19 vaccination or submit to regular testing.
We want to be sure that we're doing this the right way. I also want to be sure that we're doing this in a way that allows us to not only open our doors, but to keep our doors open.
Superintendent Joe Gothard voiced support for the plan Tuesday night. According to a staff survey, 55% say yes, they support a district-wide vaccine mandate. 37% say no, and 8% say they're still not sure.
We're in favor of a vaccine requirement.
Leah Van Dasser is president of the St. Paul Teachers Union, which urged the board to consider the requirement.
Having as many adults vaccinated as can be done safely is the best option for keeping as many of our students safe as we can.
But Leah says there are teachers who either can't get vaccinated or simply oppose getting it for various reasons. But even at a time when the district is facing a staffing shortage, she is not concerned about losing anyone to a shot.
Those folks that want to not be vaccinated will still be able to work in St. Paul and just have to follow the other guidelines that we're hoping to negotiate with the district about how that will look for people to be able to continue to work in the district and stay as safe as possible, which would include at least weekly testing.
That's the same approach being taken by Education Minnesota.
We believe that we have about 90% of educators in Minnesota who have received the vaccine. So most educators are already vaccinated, and I think that's a good thing.
President Denise Speck says it's hard to know how many other schools will adopt similar requirements, but says they could be another key to keeping schools open.
What I do know is this, we had a teacher shortage before COVID, and there certainly is a shortage now. Class sizes are high, caseloads are high. It's very, very difficult. If an educator is quarantined, or even if an educator is sick, we're just simply finding that not as many people want to be a guest teacher or substitute teacher anymore, given the challenges going on in the schools right now.
But whether it's a mask or a shot mandate, she says one thing is clear this year. The state is leaving it up to the districts for better or worse.
We're putting school districts and school boards in a position to make decisions about the health and safety of students and staff. That's a very difficult place to be in. And then to top it off, this has become very political. I never in a million years believed or even imagined that the health and safety of students and staff would become so politicized.
Yeah, well, according to Education Minnesota, data on school mandates doesn't appear to be tracked by the state of Minnesota, but St. Paul could become the third district that we know of to adopt a vaccine plan. The other two include Red Lake Schools and Intermediate School District 287, which serves about 1,000 high-needs kids in Hennepin County.